1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Self-awareness is a superpower. My name is Kathy LaDonna. Welcome to Soul and Vibration. Master Teacher number 33. Before I even get into this video, I just want to say thank you guys so much for all of the love and the support. Thank you for showing up and supporting these videos. You know, with your support, I am able to live my best life in the sense that I love to dive deep. I love psychology. I love research, and I love to help people solve problems and feel good. So I'm able to express all of that in these short videos, some of them not so short sometimes, but I'm able to express all of this in these videos, and you guys showing up and supporting this video is a beautiful example of how energy is equally exchanged. I am putting the energy out there and you guys are receiving it, and I thank you so much for that. And this video is about basically living your life purpose, finding your life purpose. Life purpose is something that most of us struggle with. And I feel like if we look back at us as humans, as a collective, race, we will see that basically because we can't all come together and collectively agree on who we are, what we are, where we came from, or what our purpose is here on earth, you know, and we see that as humans, a lot of the times we create more destruction than we do anything good. But maybe, you know, who knows if that's probably how it's supposed to be also, but who knows? But as a collective, we can't agree on our existence. And I feel like because we can't agree on our existence, we can't agree on our reason for being, which is purpose. And that's where you see the struggle within us as individuals struggling for purpose. But I don't believe purpose is what we think it is. I believe it is a lot simpler than we think. And what our purpose is as humans and individuals is quite obvious. But what holds us back from that understanding or that knowing is basically beliefs. Everything that you believe has been taught to you. None of your beliefs come from you. If you pay attention to your self-talk, some good, some bad, a lot of it you'll realize that you'll hear your mother repeat it or your caregiver repeat it or whatnot. Meaning, you know, as humans, we're programmable the same way water is programmable. So when we're around someone or anything for too long, we start to pick up and say what they say and do what they do, you know, and then we put ourselves in a box, and it takes time for us to get out of that box and know who we truly are. And that's why the master teacher number 33 will deal with procrastination or change its mind easily, because it's through those changes or procrastination, and the kind of procrastination I'm talking about, not the procrastination where you fear because you're not good enough, but the procrastination where you get bored. That's what helps you to realize that, okay, that's not the kind of experience that I want to have. Like, that's actually a good thing. And I hope you've learned not to beat yourself up about it and embrace it, because it's what helps you to know who you are. Because leading up to that, everything else is a conditioning you are taught. And a belief is something that is used to conspire towards or against something. So that's the purpose of a belief, to conspire towards or against. So we believe this, and when we believe this, it conspires towards this or it conspires against that. You know, where we never focus on what we know, and we're not encouraged when it comes to what we know, because as humans, we are meant to feel crazy when we have an experience that no one else can relate to, which that's what basically pushes us away from knowing and brings us more into the belief sector. But when it comes to the whole belief sector and what's passed down from generation to generation, a lot of the times the career paths that we take on out of guilt or obligation or social acceptance basically doesn't come from us. Like, basically it comes from, like, okay, so let me put it this way. In astrology, the 10th house rules Capricorn, or is ruled by Capricorn, and Saturn rules over Capricorn. And the 10th house is our place in the world. Basically, it's us standing at the top of a mountain where everyone can stand back and see us clearly. And because they can see all of our flaws, our imperfections, and everything about us, basically, we don't stand in that position freely because we're afraid of what other people will think. We're afraid of other people's opinions. And of course, you know, as humans, our survival depended on us being a group, as a community aspect. And the master builder number 33 knows all about community. Community is important. So a lot of the times we'll mold ourselves to be what is best for the community and not what is best for us on a whole. And I trust the universe and trust the creator in the sense that what is best for me will be best for the community if I am coming from a place of truly knowing, which is a place of love, where I'm in tune with the divine guidance that is here for me. So, like I mentioned, if I didn't already, you know, when it comes to these beliefs, a lot of the times we allow other people to live twice through us, whether it's our parents, our caregivers, whoever, because they tell us this is the path to take, so we take it. Due to their experiences, you know, they might realize, okay, you know, I should have been a lawyer, or that lawyer was so cute, like I'm gonna push him to be a lawyer or her to be a lawyer. When in all reality, I mean, in some cases that could be a good thing, where maybe it's your parents' basically their job to trigger you by planting that seed in your head, and you move towards it and you realize that's who you've always wanted to be. And in some cases, you know, it's like the book, The Four Agreements. We agree to something and then we become what other people want us to be through our agreement of it. And the mind is so powerful because we can convince ourselves that we are happy with something that we are truly not happy with. And energy does not lie. You know, even though we can convince ourselves and convince others, basically energy does not lie, in the sense that when we are genuinely not happy, we will start to experience dis-ease in our bodies, challenges in our bodies, challenges with our health. And the challenges in our bodies or challenges with our health is helping us to realize that there is a lack of balance when it comes to some aspect of our lives. So sometimes that is the only way that we are able to see what's really happening. So when it comes to us, you know, being creators, the fact of what our purpose is quite obvious. We are creative expressions of the creator. And because we are creative expressions of the creator, we are walking, talking pieces of art. And like I've mentioned in other videos, art is an experience that can change someone's life forever. So as humans, our interactions with each other are experiences that can change some of our lives forever. And as creative expressions of the creator, that energy also flows through us. So we are creators ourselves. We are co-creators. We have the ability to create. On a practical level, we could create pencil and paper with physical materials, but on an energetic level, we are able to create realms and realities for ourselves, in the sense that our purpose here on Earth is not to find our purpose, it's to accept it, and it is to create. Just the way how everything in nature is all about creation and we ourselves was created, we are creators, we are here to create, but not in the sense that, you know, we're all meant to be artists on a practical level. We are all here to create in the sense that, imagine the kind of life that you want to have, the kind of life that you could see yourself having. A lot of the times that's super hard for us because we're imagining through our insecurities and our traumas and not genuinely imagining through basically what speaks to our heart, what speaks to our souls, what we know to be true. And that's why it is the relationships and the failures that we experience that are really instrumental and meant to guide us as to what path is really meant for us. You know what I mean? Because again, like I mentioned earlier, we're living through our family members and we want to please them. So we take on these roles, these positions, these partners, these lifestyles, when that's not who we truly are. Where it's when things aren't working, our health isn't working, Discomfort is a signal for change. It is through the discomfort that we are able to make the changes that are necessary. So because we are co-creators and we can create the kind of realities that we want, sit down and think about what kind of life would you want to live? For me personally, I've created many lives and had to basically, you know, scrap it and start creating something else. Because maybe at one point I thought I wanted to, you know, be a salon owner, and it took me 5 years to realize that I don't want to open, you know, I don't want to own branches of salon or chains of salon. You know, I like the idea of being an entrepreneur. I like beauty, but that's not the way that I want to go. You know, and everything that I learned in the process, I'm able to add value to myself towards something else. You know, so everything that you learn, every experience that you have is extremely valuable, because it is important with the next thing that you're supposed to do, because it's almost like the creator, our guides, you know, already know what path we're supposed to take. And we don't know the path that we're supposed to take because, no, we know the path that we're supposed to take, but because of our conditionings and the beliefs that we hold to be true, the belief caused us to be all over the place because there's a fight going on. There's a fight going on with what's happening within us and what we are told. You know what I mean? And because of that fight going on with what we were told and what we know to be true within us, it creates an opposition. But after a while, like, you know, most of us end up giving in to ourselves. Most of us realize that it's not worth betraying ourselves for anyone or anything. And normally age is what does that. And that's the beauty about the 10th house in astrology, having to do with our legacy and the place in the world and everybody looking up at us in that position. It's like Saturn energy talks about wine. I mean, not wine. Saturn energy talks about time. And I like to compare Saturn energy to wine, where, you know, wine gets only sweeter and more delicious over time. So over time, as people, we get wiser and we get stronger within ourselves and our truth. And we get to a point where no one can tell us what path we should be taking, because based on our experiences, we refuse to betray ourselves. And choosing anything but what speaks to our soul is betraying ourselves. And we will not choose anyone or anything that isn't a part of, you know, who we are, the experience that we are meant to be having. Because life is art, and art is an experience. Like, we are art, and we are experiences also meant to be creating experiences, you know. So master teacher number 33, I've said so much, and I also feel like I'm missing something, but you know what I would like for you guys to do for me is to please drop me a course in the comment box below. The reason why I want you to drop me a horse or a moon, because that horse has a moon symbolism on the third eye. The reason why I want you guys to drop me a horse is because that horse is a wild horse, and it talks about freedom. And in order to be free, you gotta be you. It's like the saying that I've heard somewhere, if I'm gonna be free, I gotta be me. And in order for you to be you, first you have to realize, what are the beliefs that you're holding on to that's conditioning or that's directing your steps in life right now? You know, forget about beliefs and start knowing. It's time to unlearn beliefs and know. You know, what you know to be true within you cannot be debated. It cannot be debated. You just know. If anything, you know, you might try to quiet that knowing, but it only gets louder because you just know. It's like with me, for years, like, I thought I needed to pursue a glamorous calling, meaning I needed to go to college and get a degree as a psychologist. You know, I went to college, to art school, but I felt like, you know, I need to be more sociably acceptable, and I need a degree in psychology because I love psychology. I love helping other people. I love solving problems. When a psychologist in San Francisco, you know, taught me, I went to see a life coach. So she's a psychologist practicing as a life coach. And she sat me down and basically told me that my approach that I want to take in taking psychology all the way and then implementing metaphysics and the occult in order to help people is not going to be accepted. So basically, I'm going to get educated in order to diagnose people. And that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to solve problems, you know, and solve problems on a Gemini level, in the sense that not on a Sagittarius level, but on a more basically like, I'm not even gonna get into that. Or maybe I should, for those of you who are interested to know. Like, on a Gemini level is more on a social community level, where on a Sagittarius level, Sagittarius is more of a higher mind energy, all about, like, you know, going off to college, going away from your community and expanding your mind on a certain level. Like, that's something that I like to do naturally because I have a stellium in Sagittarius, but I also have a stellium in Gemini. So basically what I'm doing here with you guys is communicating on a Gemini level through entertainment. I am providing guidance. But anyways, like, regardless of all that, like, I've said so much to where I even lost my train of thought and saying and whatever it is I was saying. But anyways, please drop me a horse to represent being free. You know, the horse talks about you being completely free. It's almost like a contract, you putting the word horse because you're on the computer, or giving a horse emoji in the comments, is basically you agreeing that you're going to live your life according to your own terms, and that you living your best life in a way that suits you, that is true to you. And the moon symbolism also represents our inner world, our inner conversations with ourselves. And that also ties into what I mentioned about, you know, if you don't like the life that you're experiencing right now, it's important for you to plant new seeds. Like, our moon energy is our conversations that we're having with ourselves and how we nurture ourselves. So you won't be nurturing yourself until you are living your life according to your own terms, not how someone else wants you to live it, but how you want to live it. You know, master teacher number 33, I could go on and on forever, but I am going to end it here. Thank you so much. I look forward to hearing from you in the comments. Love yourself as if your life depended on it, because it does. Take care of yourself, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.